what destinations are the best for your road trip.
Road trip!
Road trip!
You love a road trip. You love a road trip.
We're going to be going on a 2,500-mile road trip, 3 weeks across America to go mountain biking. Certain places we're going to stop again. Others we're going to go right by. Find out which ones are what. America is such a big country, and luckily, while the East Coast is freezing over, there's the West Coast with the sun and the sand and the warmth. This will be the third time that we're doing the trip from New York all the way to Tucson, Arizona. In the past, we've stopped in Virginia, Arkansas, and Texas to go riding on the way to Arizona. Are we going to do the same this time? To figure this out, I have to bring in my travel partner in crime, Stacy. Let's talk about it.
It's the time of the year that is good and bad, because bad, it's got snow, we're cyclists, it's not great, but it's good because we get to go away for about 3 weeks.
Yay!
So that means we're trying to plan where we're going to go and ride our mountain bikes. Yeah. To figure this out, we're going to go down memory lane a little bit.
We're planning to go from New York to Arizona. It's about 2,500 miles, a long way. We've done this a couple times now, always this time of year, so it's obviously winter.
It's 106 miles to Chicago. We got a full tank of gas, half a pack of cigarettes, it's dark, and we're wearing sunglasses. Hit it.
First things first, what's with the glasses?
I'm really puffy right now and I can't do it. I just can't do it.
You can ask me what's with the hat.
And what's with your hat?
I'm really bald and it's never going to change. And we've done stops on the way. Now, certain places we might want to stop again.
Yes.
Other places we might want to bypass and find different places to go to. So let's go through past trips and maybe recommend them to our viewers to go to.
Okay.
Or maybe not to go to, depending on weather. Roanoke, Virginia.
That was really nice.
Carvin's Cove.
I enjoyed that tremendously.
Do you remember the climb?
That I didn't enjoy, but I enjoyed the downhill of the climb.
The downhill was really long.
It was really good.
Yeah. No, it's like for us in the East Coast, we don't have a lot of long, continuous downhills.
Yeah.
And that one, I thought, was surprisingly long. It felt very out west.
Where you have flowy.
Right. Super flowy, fun. It wasn't dangerous. It was an easy, it felt like an easy trail.
It was doable. I mean, we hadn't been riding off-road for a couple of months. And sometimes the first day or two, I'm a little off the back because I'm not used to riding off-road, and then it gets better. And that was a great first ride because I could just like look ahead and not worry about things and just go.
Yeah. So Carvin's Cove is a possible stop on the way out again. I would think that depends a lot on the weather. It could be cold there. So it's on the long list of going there again. So take a note of that. That's a good place.
Yeah.
The other possible route for us to drive is a little further north, which brings us through Arkansas, through Bentonville. We did the back 40. We did a ride there. The trails were great. Super well constructed and built, super flowy. Lots of ups and downs, ups and downs, ups and downs. Now, I liked the mountain biking a lot. I don't know, if I'm driving that far, I want something different. And that's just me being an East Coaster. If I'm climbing a climb and at the top I see the same trees and no view than us at the bottom, basically I'm being difficult here, because I expect a little bit more of a scenic view sometimes for the effort of climbing. Yeah. So we might not be 100% qualified to make an opinion about the whole area, because we only get one ride.
Exactly.
The ride we did was great. The back 40, can highly recommend it. Are we going to stop there on the way out?
I don't know.
No, I don't think so. I think we're just going to keep going because we want the out west experience, because we have similar riding to Bentonville here all year round. So we're just going to bypass that.
Pretty much.
Pretty much, right? Yeah, okay. Oh, this is an all-time favorite. Palo Duro Canyon.
Oh, yeah.
So because of the distance from New York to Arizona, 2,500 miles, it's a long drive, and you definitely want to have a place where you want to maybe stop for more than a day or two. So Palo Duro Canyon, just south of Amarillo, is an amazing location. And this will be our third time going to Palo Duro Canyon. So you know it's good when I'm going there a third time. And usually we spend about 2 days there, recharge. I mean, we just driven 1,800 miles, so it's nice to stay somewhere for 2 days. The camping is amazing. The scenery is amazing. You got this first time you're out west feeling. Yeah. The dirt is red. The colors are beautiful. It can be really cold there, so you have to luck out in December or January. You can have snow, freezing, cold.
God, no.
I know. So that is on the list for sure. Do you remember the ride there?
It's like a mini Moab. It's so nice. No cactus. I didn't see cactus, but it's all red. You've got like arches you ride over, little like rock plates, water, a lot of wildlife, a lot of birds, a lot of rabbits, longhorn, those big longhorn things. What are those called? The cowie things? Deer. You heard the coyotes at night. We saw owls. If you like nature and you like being in open space, it's pretty cool.
You saw an owl?
Yeah, he flew right by when we were driving that night on the road. He went, whoosh, remember?
No.
Oh, I do.
Did you have your glasses on when you saw that owl?
No, it was nighttime.
Yeah, with glasses. It was at night with glasses on.
When we were going to the trail. Plus, it's like pretty cool. You go and then you drive, what is it, like 2.5 miles down to the valley of it? So it's like this, you ride, all it's flat, and then you get to this thing, and then you go downhill for 2 miles, and then it's this expanse valley of red rock.
That's the interesting part about going to Palo Duro Canyon. The drive to it is super underwhelming. Basically, you're driving, and it's flat, and it's flat, and it's flat, and you're like, where is the mountain biking? Because you figured it should be mountain biking, but this is more like valley biking, because you're driving down into the canyon. So actually, you're in the bottom of the canyon, and you're using the walls of the canyon as mountains, so it's the reverse. It's really interesting. It's a beautiful place. That, if you're anywhere near that or driving past that, is a must stop in my eyes. 2 days, definitely can make 3 days out of it. So the last part of the journey from Palo Duro Canyon to Tucson, there's a couple ways of going. And I know once we went to Sedona, and that's highly dependent on weather, you know, December, January, because you can have cold weather like snow. I mean, it could be colder in Sedona than in New York that time of year. So that is, but you would just look at weather. But that's a definitely, I would go there again, Sedona. I mean, totally. There's so much riding there. And the riding we did, I don't remember all the words. I know we did the Canyon of Fools, which was pretty fitting. But I love that. The Mercal, I don't know. I don't know what the trails were called. I'll put it in the description. That riding was great. I know you were a little tired back then.
I was. It was a lot of riding. I needed a rest day.
Right. That's also a thing. When you're planning a road trip mountain biking, especially if you have maybe uneven riding partners, like if you have a stronger one and a weaker one, I need rest days because I can't keep up with her. No, you want to plan your rides accordingly, that you're not hammering yourself into the ground, because we've made this mistake once before, and that was the awful Moab experience where Stacy, I plan rides like day after day after day, and all the rides are great, and she feels like she's missing out. I want to do this. I want to do that. I want to do this. And I just keep going because I just feel good. And she got really tired and tired and tired and more tired. And eventually she crashed and broke her wrist because she was just too tired. And she crashed on a section that was like...
stupid.
Yeah, it was really easy. And she only really crashed because she was tired and couldn't focus because she wanted to not miss out. So
I'm such a child.
I know. But now we're doing it a little bit different. We actually bring in her e-gravel bike with us. Yeah. And so we kind of mix it up. We do like two or three mountain bike rides. And then we do a gravel, maybe road rides. Just to kind of, you know, ease up on it a little bit. Over 3 weeks riding every day, there could be a lot. And eventually you're going to get too tired and you fade and you hit technical sections and you break yourself. And that's, what's the point of this?
Thank God.
Definitely don't want to break ourselves.
No, not this time.
Also, that brings me to another part. We tend to like to go to do intermediate easy loops and rides based on the fact that we have to come back and work. I know how to ride difficult trails, but that doesn't mean I enjoy them.
Yep.
I really enjoy easy trails. This might come as a disappointment to a lot of people, but just because you know how to do difficult trails doesn't mean you enjoy them. I really like intermediate easy trails, flowy, fun, good views. Maybe that's because I'm in my 50s now, but it's kind of what keeps me sane is mountain biking. So I don't want to drive myself insane by obsessing over technical sections. If it's too hard, trust me, we're walking.
Of course. I just like an adventure, not always so hard where I'm just like beat at the end of it. I mean, I like a little bit of that, but for the most part, I just like to have fun and be like, wow, I just did that. That's pretty cool. Let's keep going.
So in general, when I see something that I know that she can ride, I give her like a thumbs up, and then it's her decision to do it or not. When I see something that's questionable, I'd be like, walk it. Or I'll even walk it because I just don't want to put the pressure on her to follow me. Also, sometimes I throw out, don't follow me, I'm stupid, which happens a lot. If you're riding with your partner and you want to stay married, you might want to do that.
It's when it's a first time trail, you don't want to like be nuts.
No, but I think it has more to do with getting tired.
Yeah, I
fatigue. Because you can literally break yourself in the parking lot if you're exhausted.
Yes.
I know.
You can't get out of your pedals.
If you're tired, you're going to make mistakes. It doesn't take anything but a pebble. All right. So eventually we'll get to Tucson. And Tucson has so much riding. And we haven't covered it all. We've done a lot of it. The one thing that we like talking about intermediate easy trails that are beautiful and fun is Sweetwater Preserve.
Oh, that was fun.
Yeah. It's just the scenery, the views of Tucson. It's just out of another world. You got the cacti.
It's like a painting.
That's like forests of cacti. It's
amazing.
Yeah. So we really enjoy that. That's super easy, flowy, intermediate. Nothing scary there.
Yeah.
But it's just one of those places that we like to go back to. Another place in Tucson was the Tucson Mountain Park. That's kind of the first place we usually go ride because it's one of the prettiest. It's got a couple good climbs in there. Super nice little single track with a couple techie turns.
Oh yeah, I remember that one.
Yeah, it goes along the hillside.
Oh, that's fine.
Yeah, but nothing too dramatic. You can make the ride short, long. You have flexibilities out and back. Yeah, there's options there. So Tucson Mountain Park. Is it definitely third time going back?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What's totally. The honeybee one I want to do?
Well, that one, we don't have any footage of that because we did that last time.
Yeah, that was awesome.
The first time ever, which was the Honeybee Canyon in Catalina. So that one, we're going to hit a second time. And there's a 35-mile loop.
Yeah.
I think 35 that we're going to do. So Honeybee Canyon is the second time. That's going to be an evergreen. We're going to go back there all the time. So if you're anywhere, you know, driving past Tucson, look up Catalina. And there's a lot more riding the Baby Jesus Rock Trail. And
so
I don't
much.
Know what that's called. That side, we're going to camp there. There's a great national park campground with hot showers.
Heated bathroom.
I know. Because it does get cold at night there. When we are west, Stacy's eyes will be unpuffy.
Oh, yeah.
She will be wearing no glasses.
It won't be so early in the morning.
All right. Oof.
When you reach the point of no return, when you feel like you've had enough, there's an angel who sings and a voice that is leading you home.
So I hope this video helped you guys plan your mountain bike trip a little bit. Some of the destinations that we went to, maybe you want to go to too. If there's something that I'm missing or we're missing that's not too far off our route, let us know in the comments, please. And then also, I would really appreciate a like and a subscribe, and I'll see you on the other side. Oh, I'm going to make more how-to videos, maybe drop-offs and berms, or I don't know, let me know when I'm out west, because
It's just nicer there right now. It's just, it's not that nice here.